must acknowledge the First Peoples. We must thank the Squamish and the Tsleil-Waututh people for allowing us to gather here to live in your unceded traditional territories and to play and to do important work. I also want to say thank you, a big thank you to the Friendship Center, to Susan Tatouche, who is busy working, I have no doubt, for the great work that she does, and the board members and all the staff and volunteers here at this very Friendship Center. I am so delighted to be here to celebrate with you and to acknowledge the First Peoples, the teachings, your culture, your strength, your courage, your resilience. Everything that you do, everything that you are, is a symbol of what should be, what Canada should be. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. I hear words from our Prime Minister, and it's nice that he wants to change the title of National Aboriginal Day to something else. But let me just say what would be even be nicer if we match action with those words. And to that end, our NDP colleagues are working hard in the House of Commons to get the government to enshrine in law the UN Declaration of Indigenous Rights into law. And that's a high member's bill that my colleague Romeo Sevenage has been working hard on and has tabled in the House of Commons. And with any luck, next year when we gather here, that will be the law enshrined in Canada. I also want to let you know as well that I am a very proud seconder of my colleague Georgina Jubilee's private member's bill in declaring that National Aboriginal Day become a national holiday. And that was just tabled last week in House of Commons. And once again, I hope that next year when we gather here, that we will all be celebrating it as a national holiday as well. So every single Canadian across this country will know the origins of where our country came from. It came from the First Peoples, all of you. An enormous advocate, an amazing, magnificent advocate, Dr. Cindy Blackstock, has been doing this work for so long. And she wants our Canadian government, and like her, I support her work, and I want our Canadian government to treat every single Indigenous child, youth in this country to have the same rights as non-Aboriginal children. Human Rights Commission's rulings and to fund every child at the same level as non-Aboriginal children in their education and to support their growth and development as equal peoples across this land. I have many, many wishes, like all of you, like the mayor here. You know, let me just close with this last one, and that is to say that this government needs to stop the Kinder Morgan project from proceeding and hear your voice and respect your voice in this conversation. If we're going to have reconciliation, talk is cheap, action is what counts. And last but not least, the one thing that I am advancing as the critic for immigration for the NDP is for our Citizenship Act to be amended so that we acknowledge and recognize the First Peoples. So when people become citizens in Canada, that they know this history and they take it to heart. And that every single day we should be thankful to you for allowing all of us to be on your land. With that, my friends, I wish all of you happy National Aboriginal Day. I brought my niece here with me today. She is not quite, well, she's three, not quite four, and this is her first community event. And I thought it's important, you know, for her too, at a young age, to also understand the history of this country and how lucky we are and how privileged we are for you to have welcomed us so many, many, many years ago. Happy National Aboriginal Day. Thank